Hello everyone, welcome back to Consortium. So as I said at the end of the last episode, I was going to learn more about the Consortium universe, since there's a lot to learn. There's a lot of backstory to this game, a lot of lore to read, and I was going to look at that and come back and apply it to a new playthrough, and I still am, but not just yet. I'm going to put that on hold for now, just for a little while, because I was thinking, all right, my first playthrough, I played the game seriously, although I didn't get to the end because of the bugs, and then in my second playthrough, my last one, I played the game seriously again, and actually got to the end. So before I do more serious stuff, I want to do a wacky playthrough. I'm going to do a playthrough that is not even close to serious. What I'm going to do is choose the dumbest, most offensive and strange and horrible options possible, just to see what happens. I want to see if I can break this game. Pretty much. I'm going to choose the dumbest stuff, just to see what happens. So let's go. Let's see how this works out. New universe. I'll go with intermediate. It doesn't matter. This should be interesting. I'm going to make people as suspicious of me as possible. I'm just going to blurt out the truth about what I am. See how they respond. They're probably going to think I'm freaking crazy. I'm certainly not going to be negotiating with Kirill. Oh no. I'm just going to piss him off too. I'm going to piss everybody off. And let's see what happens. Oh boy. Don't mind me, I'm just bouncing my way to victory.
Were found dead in a cargo container ship. The ship had initiated auto docking procedures and emergency personnel.
Who is it?
It's Rook 25. Will you open the door?
21.
No.
Dead. Well, I'm coming in anyway. Nothing you further. Better be dressed.
Lights. Camera action.
Much better.
And that's the latest.
Not
from
so
here
sorry
in
to wake you, Bishop.
I'm Malcolm Thomas.
We thought you should know about our little escort.
Who are you?
We just met 2 hours ago.
I still don't know who you are.
This isn't very funny, new guy. But you know, let's see where this goes. My name is Alana Boyle, codename Rook 25. I am your weapons and combat specialist. Do you know what your name is?
Actually, I don't. I'm your commanding officer. Never speak to me like that again.
Let's get one thing straight here, big man. You are not my commanding officer, nor will you ever be unless it's over my dead rook arse. At the risk of sounding cliche, this isn't quite your daddy's army. So let's get you suited up and ready to kick some homeless arse. Here are your basic consortium tools. You got your PCU, beef...
Hold on, how much have I pissed her off so far? -2. Okay, that's a good start.
Helmet, all specifically tailored to fit you nice and snug.
And what exactly does all that mean?
I'm not surprised you've never used this equipment before. The bloody BUS alone is so expensive. We're one of the only agencies in the world who use it. Think SSK, only with built-in hardpoint sockets.
I have absolutely no idea what you just said.
Huh? What part don't you understand?
PCU, bus, SSK, hardpoint sockets?
Are you pulling my chain?
You have a chain? Where's the chain? I don't see one. Where's your chain? No, I'm not. I've never heard of any of those things.
Well, I know the Canadian military still uses SSK, so I don't know what you're playing at on that one. You better not act like this with a K, or she'll tear you a new one.
Well, I could actually use a new one, because my old one's getting a bit... Well, it needs to be replaced. So I'm Canadian, then?
Well, that's what your file says. You sure are a strange one. You know what? You're acting a little lopsided. Maybe you should go and see Rook 13 in the med bay. I'll tell him you may be coming. It's your choice, whether or not to go, of course, but I think it's better to be safe, right? We don't want a banged up bishop on our hands. Now, Pawn 7 and I have some CCU maintenance to take care of in the lower crawl. Feel free to wander the ship and meet your new crew, or maybe hit up the virtual trainer and complete your bishop training scenario. The VT is at the end of the hall, next to the elevator. Oh, and don't forget to go and get your CMC from the K. You can find her in Mission Operations, at the end of the hall, to your right.
Let's go do my optional objective first. You know, I can never remember how the hell to get to the med bay. To go down, you need to use the elevator, right? Hello. Wait, didn't you greet me before? You didn't greet me this time.
Yes, Bishop? What can I do for you?
It was because I wasn't there when she came off the elevator. I'm only curious what you're up to.
Oh, I was just checking on something for Rook 9. He's a little concerned because we can't seem to track Angelov's location of transmit. Usually Zenlil can pinpoint where he's contacting us from, but not today.
Oh my god, I can say she seems young. Gah! I want to be a dick just to see what happens, but I don't because it's kind of painful. I'll do it. You sure sound young for this. How old are you?
Don't you know not to ask a lady that? I'm not much older than you are, I'm sure.
You can be such a dick. Answer your bishop's question, now!
Answer my bishop? Yeah, that's not gonna happen. We are equal parts, Bishop. You are the muscle, and we are the brains. At least that's how it was with Bishop 8.
Okay.
Anyway, if you don't mind, I have to go check in with Rook 9 now. Hey, and try to avoid Pawn 1 if you're screaming at someone on the first day.
So how many people hate me so far? 2. Let's see if I can make that 3 or 4. Oh yeah, that's right. Adele Duran going to the bathroom or something, whatever the hell she's doing in there. Hello.
Bishop 6, welcome to the medical bay.
This place is disastrous. I do apologize.
Oh, come on, Kieran. Greet our new bishop.
Bishop? It's nice to see you again.
I'm gonna say nothing.
No, Bishop. Alana was telling me you were acting strange earlier. Said you seemed a little mixed up. If you'll just step over here and lay down, I'll run a full body scan. Just to be sure.
Well, don't be afraid,
this will just take
Bishop.
A few seconds.
He's perfectly harmless.
I don't like not being able to move.
Don't be such a wuss. How is that even possible?
I'm not entirely sure. Bishop, you have more simultaneous synapses firing than what should be possible. It's as if there are 2 of you, housed within the same brain.
2 of him? That doesn't make any sense, does it? Is this some kind of anomaly?
Yes. Unless the bishop has an explanation for us.
I've traveled here from an alternate dimension.
This is really no time to be making jokes. This could be highly dangerous. The human brain isn't built to handle so much activity. Whatever this is, I'd certainly like to run some more scans from our base in BC. Maybe after your induction ceremony. Now, we've got a lot more cleaning to do around here.
You mean you do? I will return to my command VR, if there is nothing else you need, Bishop.
I'm just gonna say nothing. Awkward.
Good day, Bishop. It was really nice meeting you.
Okay. Brainy. Go pick up my kunk.
Six, welcome to Mission Operations. First things first, here is your Consortium Mind Communicator. Please, just call it a CMC. Hearing Consortium Mind Communicator over and over just gives me a headache. Consortium officers only need to think what we'd like to say to each other, and the CMC will do the rest.
Can you hear me? Hello?
Loud and clear. It'll take some time for you to get used to the feeling, but you'll get it.
You mean the feeling of having voices in my head?
Well, yes, actually. After a short while, though, it becomes like second nature. I promise.
I'm just gonna be silent.
Okay, Six. Before you move on to something else, I wanted you to officially meet Rook 9, Captain of Zenlil.
G'day, B. Glad to have you here with us. And the name is actually Wade. Just stick to Wade. Lay off the Rook 9 nonsense, eh?
Where are you?
Where do you think the pilot would be, mate? The CMC you just stuck in your ear can transmit as far as the bloody moon. We've tested it.
Impressive. Everything today is just so overwhelming.
Yeah, I have those days too. Don't worry though, mate. Kirill blusters a lot, but he's pretty much harmless.
I don't know where I am, or who you people are.
Right, yeah. Wait, what did you say?
You heard me.
Christ, Satan. I certainly don't make them any less crazy, do they?
I guess not.
So hey, all kidding aside, give me just a few minutes to finish up this diagnostic, and then I'd like to get a look at you in person.
For now, I want you to walk around a little and meet your new crew. Most of them are eager to meet you.
How the hell did I come away from that with them liking me? They actually like me. Alright, well, let's see if I can piss off some more people.
Hey, hi. How are you? Oh my gosh. You're Bishop Six! Oh, it's amazing to meet you. Did you know that the old Bishop Six left the Consortium early 2040? Yep, he just up and left. He's a stay-at-home dad now. Go figure. He lives in Florida with his wife and his two kids. Beautiful family. Beautiful, beautiful family. Love them.
Are you feeling okay?
Yep, feeling good. Feeling great, in fact. I'm really happy to have met you before your first mission. You're bound to be a popular one with your less-than-stellar record and everything. Not that I think like Pawn 1 does. No, I just, I don't know. I'm sorry.
Screw Pawn 1.
That's what I said, too. He's just upset over Bishop 8. He'll get over it, though. You just watch. Try saving his life. That would help.
So, Pawn 12... What's your real name, anyway?
Pawn 12, David Benedict, at your service. Well, not literally at your service, unless you want me to be, because I could be at your service, although, you know, nothing that goes over the line. But, you want me to get you some coffee?
Stop that. What is your problem?
I'm just really excited to meet you. I have so many Bishop collectibles and games at home, my mom thinks I need a shrink. But she also says I'm too quiet and awkward. Both of which are true, I guess.
I don't know about you being quiet. You certainly are awkward, though. You're certainly not very quiet right now. Oh, wait a minute. No. I have to go with the second option. So, you're smitten by me?
Nothing like that, sir. I just think you're doing the world an invaluable service. If you're doing a service, then I'm doing you a service, and therefore I'm helping the world do an invaluable service, and I feel like I'm part of that, and it's really, really, really exciting.
In other words, yes, he's quite smitten by you.
Don't call me sir. Nobody else does.
Oh, right. I guess you're not really my boss. It doesn't really feel that way, does it? I mean, you're a big, powerful bishop and everything, and... Let's face it, I'm just me.
What do you do for the consortium, anyway?
Me? Well, I'm glad you asked. Myself and Pawn 19, we actually monitor the environmental concerns within the grid. We keep an eye on the power plants, the industrial zones, polar levels, the ozone levels, impacts from climate change, ocean levels and acidification, nanopollution, deforestation. The list just goes on.
By monitor, you mean you spy on everyone?
Sort of. Yeah, I guess so. But it's all in the intention, though, right? And since we have good intentions, well, that makes it A-okay in my book.
And if a law is broken, then what?
Then the king sends us right in. Well, in a lot of cases, actually, environmental problems are resolved easily enough by Knight 15. She's incredibly good at convincing people to lay down without a fight. And if a show of force is required, well, then that's your territory.
Silence.
I'm gonna go back to work now, then. Maybe we could go get a drink sometime together. My sister, she'd love an autograph from you.
I think he's played too many Consortium video games.
I'm surprised these people are not getting pissed off at me. With the options I chose, I thought I would have pissed him off, but no. Alright, well here we go, I can piss him off. Hey, Gary.
I'm a little busy right now.
Really? What are you up to?
Nothing, never mind. I've just got a headache, and I don't feel like talking right now.
No, but I really want to know. What are you doing? It looks so exciting. How about you tell me why you're so annoyed?
Bishop, I simply don't think you're right for this post.
You don't know a damn thing about me.
Uh-huh. Well, I've also personally spoken to some of your previous commanders, and they all tell me that you were...
Silence.
Nothing to say, Bishop?
Tell me my full name and where I grew up.
Is this some kind of joke? Your name is... and you spent the first 15 years of your life in... Satisfied? Good.
I'm sorry about him. Don't let it bother you. He's been rather attached to Bishop 8 since 8 saved his life the 4th or 5th time.
You should have reprimanded him.
I don't think so, Six. So not on my
what's
ship.
What's going on?
I encourage everyone under me to always speak their mind on all matters, systems. Good or bad.
I still can't find him. The king is probably just running his own checks. You want my professional opinion, though? Those systems are fine.
Then Angelov is protecting himself somehow. I've never seen anyone able to hide where they're transmitting from. Not from K1. It's impossible.
I'm sure it's nothing to worry about.
Who's worrying? This is all pretty exciting. I wonder how he's doing it.
You've been doing this for far too long. What will the criminals try next? It's not a game you want to play with so much enthusiasm. Karma will come around and bite you in the rear.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. Anyway, I'll leave you alone now. I got what I wanted.
Oh, and here I thought you'd never let me work today.
Who else should I speak to? Let's go talk to... what was his name? The guy who plays video games. Who talks really fast, this guy, Charlie.
Well, hey, the new bishop! I've got a few minutes to talk if you want. How was your sleep? Those bunks up there can be pretty comfortable. They're 60% made of hemp. Canadian hemp, the best in the world.
I can't feel the bunk because it's not my skin.
Well, what? I mean, what's that you just said? About your skin?
Being Bishop Six feels like wearing new skin.
I'll bet it does. I felt the same when I made the switch from working for an airline. Like going from being a fly to an Andean condor.
A little bit different here, but okay.
All right, V. You'll start to feel right at home. Cockpit.
No.
Come by and say hi.
Bishop, I didn't hear you come in. I have to get back to work.
Bye.
Wait a second, Mackay. Not so fast. Are you coming to the party or not? We're having it before you leave for home, the second we're done in BC. No excuses will be accepted.
No, I can't. I'm sorry.
No, I'm going to block him in and you convince him, okay? I'm going to block him in here until you can convince him to come to the party, okay? Come on. Convince him. Quick. He's overcoming me. I can't hold him anymore. Fine, you win. Excuse me. Awkward. Excuse me. There we go.
So, Bishop, I was just playing a game with my brother, but he had to go and take care of something. Do you need anything else from me? I'd be happy to chat, at least until my brother gets back.
What was wrong with him?
Pawn 64? Who knows? He refuses to come to the party we're throwing for you and Rook 13. Says he won't go if Rook 13 is there. What's that about? And who turns down a chance to party?
I don't know. What the hell was that about? Jesus. How about I try and convince him to come?
Really? Well, if you don't mind, yeah, that would be great. I'm sure he'll listen to you. I'm sorry, Bishop. I've got to get back to my game. My brother's back and we don't have much time to finish this level. We'll talk later, I promise.
Oh yeah, I just remembered. At one point, I wanted to look at the traitor's whatever pictures she had on her bed, but I'd accidentally closed it and I couldn't unclose it, so which one is hers? So it's this one. Right here, yeah. Oh, that's it? Just one picture? Some dude? Is that the husband she was forced to kill? Who else? Doctors. I think it's just the people back here.
You know it as well as I do, Patricia.
Do you really want to get into this now? She could come back from the floor at any second.
Do I look like I care? Let her hear me. I do not deserve this kind of
treatment. What are you talking
about? Hmm? And it's time she understands this.
What kind of treatment? You've only been here a month and you're already complaining.
She does not need to treat us like ants to be stomped on.
Can we just get back to work, please?
Fine. But I will not let her push me around anymore.
Yes, whatever you say.
A serious observation here. He just said, treated like ants to be stomped on. A serious question for anyone. Has anyone actually tried to stomp on ants? I have. I've tried to stomp on ants. It's really, really difficult. Because they're so tiny that they usually just... They'll just, you try to step on them, and then they just end up going between the treads, and they're perfectly safe. Shoes are typically not completely flat on the bottom. They have treads. Which means they have peaks and they have valleys. Ants are tiny. They often don't go on a flat kind of part. It's actually really hard to stomp on ants, unless you have, like, I don't know, what the hell kind of a shoe has a perfectly flat bottom? But yeah, normal shoes? No.
Good afternoon, Bishop. I'm sorry you had to hear all that.
Just like my being here, I had no choice.
There's always a choice, Bishop. The good Lord saw fit to give us the gift of choice, and you chose the Consortium. Your choices as a bishop will in turn affect countless lives. Are you sure you're prepared for such a responsibility?
Nope. I mean,
I was born prepared.
No, I think you were born for something else.
What is that supposed to mean?
Oh, nothing much. I've just heard some things about you that I'd rather not repeat. You've got quite the history.
So, what does one do for fun around here?
If I didn't know better, I'd call that a pickup line.
And if it was meant as a pickup line?
Well, I'd kindly tell you, as I've done the last dozen officers to try, that I don't date within the consortium. Of course, there's also the small detail of me being married.
Oh, come on, you're not married. You killed your husband as part of some initiation rite, you traitor. Who cares about such details? I am the bishop.
I think 8 once said the exact same thing to me. It didn't work for him, and while you're quite a bit cuter, it won't work for you.
How is my standing with her actually improving? So, I'm cute then?
Very funny, Bishop. Don't you have something better to be doing? I'm sorry, Bishop, but I've got some work in Upper Avionics to take care of. Wade mentioned something about environmental monitors acting funny, and he wants me to check it out.
Huh. Turns out it's kind of hard to make people not like you. Well, actually, it's not exactly going to be true with this guy.
Oh, hey. I know you probably want to know me and all that crap, but Rook 25 has just stuck me with many of Pawn 7's duties. I am a little busy.
But I want to talk.
Oh, you do you? The bishop wants to talk. Okay, bishop. I can give you a second. What would you like to talk about?
What do you think of Rook 25?
She's a bitch. I didn't make this clear enough before. Any more questions?
She's also your boss. Show some respect.
No, Your Highness. I will not be showing her my respect. This is not the military.
I shall look down upon my peon.
I do not have to take her abuse.
But you like having a job, don't you?
Like having a job? Are you serious? I wouldn't even be here if it was not for my pushy mother. She's friends with David Shelter, and she just had to put me on his radar.
Now that explains a lot.
Oh, don't give me that. You don't know anything about me. Now, if you don't mind, I have work to do, Bishop.
Right, so his character seems to be the red herring. He certainly is very suspicious, but he's not the traitor. Speakers wait in the cockpit, convince Pawn 64 to come to your party.
My sister's going as well. She's never been to
I know I can't talk to them yet, no point. Alright, where's 64? I think he just wanders around, like a lost little puppy. He's usually on the floor up, isn't he? I think I've seen him wandering around here. Not here. I think? No. Sorry, wrong way. Yes, this way. Don't I usually see him up here? Where the hell is he? There you are.
Oh, hello, Bishop. I don't really have the time to talk right now.
Pawn 44 is worried about you, you know. Don't back away. It's okay. No need to back away. I won't hurt you.
Yeah, well, he doesn't understand. It's not something I can explain to you either. I'm sorry. Not yet, anyway.
What am I walking on top of? Wow, he's really scared of me, isn't he? What the hell? What? What is happening? Don't tell me right now, that's an order!
An order? Excuse me? Wake up and look around, Bishop. This is the consortium, and you are not my boss. Please, don't bother me again.
Well, at least he hates me. What are you doing? I'm just gonna leave now. Alright, time to go check out Wade's cock. Pit.
That is the holographic situation room. It's where you can watch dirty holovids when you're bored and feeling lonely.
Whoa, I am listening to this, you know.
Okay, Mum. Oh, hey, boss. I was just telling the bishop about the dirty holovids.
All jokes aside, the holo situation room is actually for mission briefings and debriefings, usually led by the king or the queen.
I was getting to that part, I swear I was.
Sorry about that, V. Welcome to the nerve center of everything Zenlil. You see all those buttons and switches all over the place? I actually know what they do, every one of them. How's that for impressive?
Can I talk to him? Are we gonna have a conversation? Am I done talking to him? What the? Huh. Normally there's a long conversation, but not this time. Not sure if I broke the game, or it's just because it doesn't like me as much, or... I don't know. I still need to convince him to come to the party. Still don't think I have a way to do that, though, especially not now that I've pissed him off. Let's do the training. As quick as possible.
Guys, I think I've got something here. I've been keeping a line open on our two fighter escorts outside, hoping they'd break the silence and speak to Angelov. Well, one of them just did. And, well, you gotta hear this for yourselves. Tell me if you want me to patch the recording through your CMC.
No thanks.
No problem. Hey, B. If you wouldn't mind, would you do me a quick favor and go and look inside Bishop 8's old cabin?
Of course. Sure.
Something or someone just tripped the panel sensor on 8's bus locker. It's probably just another in a string of bizarre glitches. But you never know. My girl's been feeling a little under the weather today, it seems. Well, if you're up for it, I'd appreciate the help. The cabin's right across from yours, you can't miss it. Go take a look, and I'll keep an eye out through your CMC.
Did you just say you'll keep an eye out through my CMC?
We can see through you as long as your CMC is jacked into your head. Didn't anyone jump in anything? Us rooks, and the boss, yeah, everywhere you go. Except when you go to the bathroom, of course. There's an automated privacy setting.
Okay, but what about if you're just, like, sleeping? God, that's creepy. I'm just gonna say nothing. I'm gonna say nothing. Say nothing. Nothing. Lights.
Help.
Oh my god.
Wait, lock down that cabin immediately.
Way ahead of you, boss.
Is that Pawn 7? But I was just with him 2 minutes ago. What happened?
Rook 13, will you please quietly get up there? And don't tell Pawn 24 anything. We need to contain this before the whole ship finds out.
Yes, sir. On my way.
I don't...
Should probably make a perma-save. Yeah, I'll limit Ave. Ave 1.
Sorry, 6, but I need you there. At least until Rook 13 can take a look.
You can't do that.
I sure can, mate. You just watch me.
Just take it easy. Let Rook 13 do his job first, and then we'll go from there.
Okay, Wade. Let me in. My gods. I just let him go on his lunch break. He was complaining about having skipped breakfast. I was only trying to be nice for once.
Alana, you have nothing to blame yourself for. If there is someone to blame for this, then I trust he or she will come forward on their own.
Wade, I am here.
I just can't believe he's dead. I've been such a bitch to him lately.
You're more often than not a bitch to everyone. Not only Pawn 7.
Suck it up. I mean, he's only a red shirt.
I know what that means, you know, and that's really disrespectful. So how about you just shut up?
It looks as though someone threw his head against the locker panel with enough force to nearly cave in his skull. This was absolutely no accident.
Thank you, Kieran. You are not going to like this, but I want you all to exit the room immediately. Nobody gets in or out, not until we reach Ireland.
Are you kidding me? At least let us move him to the med containment unit.
Here, Kieran, help me put him on the bed.
Wait, this is a crime scene.
Is that some kind of joke?
You can't just move a body like that.
It doesn't matter. Let them move him. We've got all the evidence we need for our people in Ireland to figure out exactly who else was there.
Alana will also likely stab you in the eye if you try to stop her. My sister can be sometimes over-emotional.
I think you're a bit under-emotional.
My book.
What was that, Kieran? Your book? Mind explaining what your book was doing under the dead body of one of my pawns?
I cannot explain that to you because I do not know. I noticed it was missing from the medbay this morning. I simply assumed someone had borrowed it. I was apparently correct.
Let's put Rook 13 in the brig just in case.
Don't be juvenile, Six. Nobody goes in the brig until we know for sure they belong there. Now, Alana, I hear your concern, but we can't risk someone seeing you move his body to the medbay. I'm sorry, but forget about the containment unit for now. All of you, listen to me very carefully. This stays between us. I swear that we'll get to the truth when we land in Ireland and we can question everyone individually.
I really don't think waiting is a good idea. Someone on board this plane just killed one of my people and I want to know who. If only so I can personally string him up and throw him in the brig.
Hold on just a second. Alright, back to it. I think an eye for an eye is in order here.
You mean kill them? Are you insane? Capital punishment isn't exactly the consortium way, Bishop.
Six was undoubtedly only joking. Extremely inappropriately, I might add. Now, if you don't mind, get your asses out of that room.
Yes, sir.
This is so bloody insane. A murder on a C-3800. It can't be real.
I'm going back in the crawl.
See, Angelov's two fighters have just multiplied into two dozen. Still not in my go-get handle.
Six and Kieran.
Whatever bishop we have aboard.
Now is your chance
your
to meet
concern.
The great Bulgarian
nuisance. Let us stick
nuisance.
To you telling me the point
he's on
of this encounter.
Now, and he's acting,
if you wish me to let
well,
you through my airspace,
you
will show me Bishop Six.
Your airspace? How many times have we gone over this, Carol? Just don't do anything you'll regret later. Not like last time we saw you.
I regret nothing. Those men died with honor.
You see? I'm not trying to play any games here. I'm only trying to prevent this from turning ugly. Again.
Good. Good. This is very good. And how is Bishop Six? You are feeling strong, I hope. Ready for your first day?
Who is this man speaking to me?
This here is Kirill Angelov, the single most irritating mercenary in all of Eastern Europe.
Oh, come on now. Alana, after all these years, this is all you have to say about me. I am hurt.
Enough posturing. Either tell me what you want or get out of our way.
You have no idea what is happening here. Poor little girl. Your king must be blind.
Did we not just go through this song and dance a month ago? And did your daddy not give you a good spanking for it?
My father will not be coming to your rescue this time, knight.
Come now, Kirill. It's Christmas. How about you let us pass, and we'll get into this another time. I promise. How does next Tuesday look for you?
Listen very carefully. You will land and surrender your warship immediately.
Yes.
If you do not, I will blow you out of the sky.
You've got to be kidding me. Give me a minute to confer with my people.
Clearly you do not understand. Comply now, or I will take Zenlil from you by force.
A minute, Kirill. That is not a request. One, will you please inform local authorities of our location and to expect possible plane debris to follow?
I'm already on it, sir.
Can you see now why I've called you all here?
Oh, yes. He's probably just blowing smoke. But there's an edge to him I've not seen before. I mean, he's usually hopped up on himself, but never has he outright threatened to kill us.
It's no doubt his attempt at revenge for what Bishop 8 did. The subject of his intelligence is one of constant debate around here.
Well, I think he's
That's,
not...
What's his name? Rook 13? Yeah, Rook 13. He's talking, but he's not actually in here.
Sorry, Six, but Mission Ops is locked down during hostile encounters.
It's very deceiving, though.
It's protocol, you understand. Old
planes he just talked, he's supposed to be standing here, but he's not, he's outside. Bardo,
the love his men have
Weird.
Him. I think it's a very intelligent role he plays to feed his all-encompassing ego and get what he wants.
You give him far too much credit.
So you're a knight and a psychologist. Anything else?
Well, you'll just have to wait and find out. One of my majors in university was, after all, criminal psychology.
Mm.
Now, let's see if I can't deflate his bloated ego a little. Put him back on.
Angelov is no longer transmitting.
Wait a second. Sorry, boss, we got company. Looks like a... Well, it's a bloody boarding carrier. It's only a few hundred meters behind us.
How did it get so close?
I can't explain it. It just came out of nowhere. But it's also emitting some kind of scrambler signal. I can't get a lock. What the hell is... I've detected two new incoming F-35s. One's a few kilometers behind the other. There's a gathering energy source of some kind coming from the lead fighter. He's 7 kilometers off the port side now, and he's closing fast. 5 kilometers. If I could just bypass the
there he is.
Regain targeting control.
You better make it quick.
There is no way he's that stupid.
I've almost got it. 3 kilometers.
What the hell is that thing?
Wait, the Habitat 5124 incident. I think this is the same delivery system Stormbird reported.
Wade?
She'll hold up, boss. I bet my life on it. We may have ourselves a problem.
Auxiliary fuel reserves online.
Just have a seat over here and relax.
Secondary turbine.
Thanks, Doc.
Where's the second fighter, Wade? Talk to me!
I can't see a bloody thing, boss.
Guys?
Not a bloody thing.
Guys, you may want to... Oh, shite! Get down!
Save Pawn 1 from dying.
Is everyone all right, Beck?
I don't really feel like it.
We've got two down and a room riddled with bullet holes.
Bishop,
what the hell just happened?
Your PCU
I haven't got an answer
over there.
I'm sorry.
Before he bleeds
no bullet
out
in existence.
Yeah, I really don't feel like it. I'm sorry,
it
Doctor. I don't feel like healing him.
Just
kind of a douchebag.
Wade, we need you focused.
Bye!
Now. Tell me about your girl. How badly is she hurt?
Yes, sir.
God, I'm such an
it
asshole.
Looks like she's broken bloody back. We've got major shipwide failures, our weapons, primary engines, cargo containment unit. They're all out.
Okay, wait. I want our primaries back online, and I'd also like to be able to shoot at the bad guys.
Half an hour for primaries, 15 to 20 minutes for manual work.
Did his dead body just talk
just
to me?
Do the best you can, and do it
with like some creepy slow motion voice.
Yes.
Is that what just happened?
I see.
I can't do it again.
Six, be prepared to aid Rook 9 in defending.
Weird. Sorry, what? But I've not been trained for that yet.
Why am I not surprised?
Alana! And Six, this is no time for jokes, and that was not a request. Just be ready. All right. Let's hear what he has to say for himself.
Now are you prepared to surrender, little girl?
Drop the ridiculous act, for God's sake. This is not like you, Kirill. You just shot up two of my people with that little stunt. And if you think, even for a second, that you're going to get away with that, you have another thing coming.
Tell me something. How does the cold hand of death feel as it takes its grip around your throat?
I think I can stall him for a little bit, but we need a better plan than this.
Have you completely lost your mind? If you destroy this vessel, you will only bring the full might of the Consortium down on you.
I'd say it's pretty simple. We stall long enough to fix our guns, and then we flip his arse back to mercenary oblivion.
Kirill's temper will never give us enough time.
I have grown to enjoy your company. Whereas a little sister.
Let him
to
use
me,
the boarding carrier.
Bishop was once
excuse me.
Brother.
Say that again, Kieran.
Let him use the carrier. When he boards, we simply separate the head from the snake.
And when only his men board us instead,
Kieran has a point.
You claim to be a politically driven mercenary, whose worst crime before today was raiding some cargo flights and kidnapping a low-level politician or two.
Egomaniac
you
that he
are
is.
Small time, Angelov. All of this madness today is far beyond your threat level.
Threat level?
You how are you using your CMC and talking simultaneously?
I was going to ask the same question.
Now is not the time. Remind me later and I'll tell you. Right, so we let him think he's won, and the rest should fall into place.
Make a mistake?
You? Make a mistake? Like when you got hijacked running, what was it? 5 tons of black market ex-gon materials from Lebanon to Baghdad? Those murderous Syrian and Iraqi mercenary groups chasing you, they sure didn't like you being in their airspace, did they? Hey now. That sort of sounds familiar, doesn't it?
I will only put up with so much disrespect, Knight.
I'm sorry, Kirill. Really. But you do have me in an extremely difficult position here.
And so we come full circle. To the point. You will inform your Rook 9 that he is to land Zenlil at the coordinates I have already given him. Run along now and do what you are told.
But we don't have enough fuel to reach the coordinates you have given us. Your EMP killed our primaries, and I'm assuming that you'll never let a refueling ship anywhere near us. If you'll only listen to me for 2 minutes, I think I have a solution.
Do your crew a favor and stop speaking. Let the men talk. Bishop Six, may I speak to you for a moment? Just a little chat before your knight forces me to shoot you down.
What was that? I think there's something in your throat.
A bishop with some kick. Very nice. I'm sure Alane is just clawing at your belt buckle by now. Is she not?
Keep it up, Angelov. I'm gonna stamp that grin into the back of your head.
Angelov. Let you and I focus
this
on-
This is no negotiation. And did I not just tell you to stop speaking? So, Bishop, all of this excitement on your first day, you must be feeling a little overwhelmed.
Keep him talking, Six, and don't make him angry.
Knight 15, let's stop playing with him and end this.
What is he talking about?
Scaring him is probably not the best move here.
I don't care. Tell him, or let me pull the damn trigger.
Speak to me, not her.
He just can't keep his mouth shut. It's nothing, Kirill. We don't have anything.
We can't wait for him to mess up.
Is that what this is? You think you have the upper hand somehow?
Rook 9 could destroy you at any second.
No, I can't.
I like your ferocity. Keep it up, please. Show me that killer inside of you. Maybe you can tell me what it felt like to find Bond 7's dead body.
You son of a bitch! What did he just say? What did you just say?
So you've not told your Bonds. Why don't you have someone take a look inside what was once Bishop 8's cabin? Do not look to her for permission! Look at me!
It's okay, 19.
I can go look myself. It'll only take a minute.
You will not leave this room! You will call another Bond to look, now! And put them on the loudspeaker.
Patricia, come in, please.
Is that you, 19? Why are you calling me Patricia?
We have a bit of a situation up here. Please don't ask me any questions. Can you just do me a huge favor and go look inside Bishop 8's old cabin? Get back to me on this line ASAP and don't come to Mission Ops.
Sure, of course. Give me just a few minutes.
Wade, go ahead and unlock the cabin for her.
It's done.
All right, Kirill. Now that you've stirred up even more trouble, let's get to it, shall we? What can we do to make you go away?
Go away? But we were just getting started!
keep this up and I'll finish what 8 started.
Are you kidding me?
Not yet, Bishop. Soon I will give you that chance, but not yet.
Alright, you win. Let's talk about her surrender.
Excellent decision, and I'll get to that in a minute. Now, about Pawn 7. Speak now, or I will order my men to take no prisoners when they storm your ship and end your life.
I will kill anyone who boards this ship.
Excellent. That is the spirit I was promised when I took this job. They said you would appear to have no fear, that you were a steely-eyed, cold-blooded killer. This should be fun.
I can't believe his arrogance.
That sound, ladies and gentlemen, it's the sound of a border carrier tearing a hole through our hull.
Tell me lockdown systems are up and running.
They are.
Good. Let's get everyone in here then.
All personnel.
Elana, show the Bishop what we've got for him.
Yes, sir. We do have ourselves an emergency weapons locker.
Excellent. So I can use weapons to make up for my incompetence.
In there, you'll find a couple weapons to choose from.
A rather large contingent of mercs is now entering the hangar.
Get ready, Six.
I've locked down every possible exit.
Can you stop them or not?
I can keep them off of Mission Ops, lower avionics, and cockpit, but that's about all I've got.
All right, Six. Get to the hangar bay and stop them from flooding the ship.
Okay, well, I have 900 shots, so I think I can do that. Sorry, Gary. Or whatever your name was. It was Gary, wasn't it? I think so. Hello? I think I'm going the wrong way. Am I going the wrong way? No, I'm not going the wrong way.
Watch out for the airlocks. They won't hold up much abuse.
Need to heal up a bit here.
Let's try and keep a few more alive, okay?
No thanks. Oh, there he is. Grenades! Ow, I just blew myself up. Oops. Did I just blow that open? I think I just blew that open or somebody else blew it open. It's like I just got sucked out for a second, but yeah, apparently I'm fine.
Explain to President Angelov why we decided it was necessary to kill his son. That should be fun.
Seriously, Bishop. I thought I asked you not to kill them.
You did. I just don't care.
All right, people. I think we've only got a minute or two before our friends out there start playing not so nice.
And our weapons?
We're good to go on this end, boss. Let's see what that Bishop can do.
Before he heads for the guns, I've got an idea. Can you patch me into the F-35s?
No problem. You're on.
Pilots are threatening homeless mercenaries. I am Knight 15, commanding officer of the consortium vessel Zenlil. Your leader has just thrown his life away in an attempt to take control of this vessel. He please. I beg you to disengage immediately so that further loss of life can be prevented. Refusal to comply will result in a fight you cannot possibly hope to win.
Nice speech, but maybe that wasn't such a good idea. Listen to this.
We will see Angelov again in the next line. They will pay for this, and they will pay for it dearly.
They're all beginning attack patterns. None of them are running away. This is about to get real ugly.
Well, honor among thieves, I guess. Who knew?
Bishop, I need you on the guns right away.
You can access the manual weapon system through the command interface inside mission operations.
I'm gonna go a little bit crazy with the lasers.
So this is Zen's manual weapons control interface. Now let's get this thing done. Quick crash course before I let you at it. Your left control can lock and release non-lethal EMP tip missiles. Aim the cursor, then press and hold to lock onto a target. Once a lock's been made, the missile will fire on its own and harmlessly swat your target from the sky.
Actually, I don't seem to be able to use the right click right now. I guess
right control is Zen's point defense laser. It's most useful for destroying incoming missiles.
Oh, that works. That works.
So try not to take it there, and that's absolutely necessary.
I'm actually running out of juice.
Keep your bloody energy up, or those bullets will tear us apart. It's getting a little rocky up here.
Oh, you're fine.
You really don't have to kill so many.
I think I do. I feel like I do. All done?
You really don't have to kill so many.
Okay. Now I'm a mass murderer.
Your first time. Just try not to use the bloody death laser so much.
You cannot criticize his decisions. That is not your job.
Well, I like to think it's my job to help keep our bishops from becoming homicidal maniacs. If you don't mind.
And you barely let a damn thing hit us. Very nice shooting, B. A real natural.
And six. Now that everyone knows, I want you to start an internal investigation into the murder of Horn 7. Just ask around a little, but don't push too hard. I'll be in global ops with my head in my own work.
Come on, finish healing. There we go. Alright, let's have a little chat. Hello? Didn't it just say talk with her? Now it's gone? Or, might have bugged out. Hey, you can't talk with you either. Gotta find somebody to talk to.
I've got something I need to do real quick. I'll meet you back here in a few minutes.
Gonna see your secret, friend?
Please, don't start.
I'm only teasing. I need to go to the washroom anyway. Go say hi for me. Hello, Bishop. Killing Angelo was a little...
Ah, you can actually see the conversation that starts right before she goes to the cockpit to see Wade. What if I go in there before she goes? Wait, can I go in there? No, it's locked. Okay.
Have you got a second?
Ah, I can sneak in behind... But... Shit. No, I'm stuck in the door! What the hell? I don't know why it just opened for a second. Shit. Yeah. I guess I'll load my game. That's what I get for trying to be a pervert.
Crazy, by the way.
Well, he says he's going to the bathroom, so let's follow him.
Hello, Bishop. Killing Angelo was a little bit crazy, by the way.
Thank you. You gonna go to the bathroom? I'll help you out. No? Oh, no. Oh, okay, I'm out. What are you doing in there? Hmm? Okay, I'll leave you alone.
Come on, guys. We got another
Oh, no. Oh, not a chance. You get the hell away from me.
Okay.
Puta, damn you. Oh, hello, Bishop. Come back to ask me out again, have you? I am only joking. Relax. I must say, though, I am glad to see you're still with us after everything earlier. Someone sure has your number, don't they?
You could say that.
Do you have any idea why that pirate would do what he's done? Why he wanted to kill you?
How do you know he wanted to kill me?
I think everyone knows you were the target. You can thank Power 19 for that. But you can never trust what Angelov says. Ever.
So, did you murder Pawn 7?
Well, yeah. Of course I did. He was the sweetest kid on this plane, and I just murdered him for no good reason.
Hooray! Mystery solved!
Lock me up and throw away the key.
Okay, well, now I have to actually ask about Pawn 7?
Yes, I know. I understand. The only time I've left this room was when I went to Upper Avionics for a few minutes. I went through the third level, access from Global Ops, nowhere near the cabins.
Just gonna say nothing.
Is there anything else you need?
No, really. I'm good.
Pawn 32, come here for a second. And Bishop, you can flirt with her later.
Just give me 2 minutes.
Ugh, leave that stupid thing. It'll still be broken when you get back. If you're here to question my people, wait for them to finish. If you're here to question me, do it later.
Question us? Come now, Bishop. There is really no need.
I'm just gonna say nothing.
It doesn't really matter, does it? Hold first, then you can chit-chat until hell freezes over. So, next on the Let's Give Thanks to Kirill Angelov repair list is to manually reboot and diagnose the atmospheric shielding. Wade says he's prepped it for a diaper change, and I hope you're up for the job.
And Bishop, we could really use some help around here with all of these repairs.
I think.
Let me know when you have a minute.
Good. And don't let the bishop or anyone else distract you. I don't care what they want.
No problem.
I don't really feel like helping you with the repairs. I'm supposed to just speak to the crew.
We've almost got them all. Just take it easy.
I don't know, this machine, it sort of makes me nervous. Oh, and hey, Bishop.
Everything, it seems, makes you nervous.
What's that supposed to mean? Are you saying you think I killed Pawn 7? Because I didn't have anything to do with that. I was in mission ops the whole time. Ask anyone, really, anyone at all.
No, Kieran, bad Kieran. Just take it easy, okay? Nobody is accusing anyone of anything.
I'm sorry, I... doesn't matter. So, Bishop, thanks for coming to see me. I'm just, you know, getting these huge fragments taken out of me. The doc here says those experimental bullets should have blown me to bits. It didn't hurt at all. Nope, not one bit. Not at all. Nope, no. No siree, no. Have you ever been shot before, Bishop? I'll bet you have.
Is there something wrong with your vocal cords? They seem to vibrate far too often, and at an incredible rate.
I was going to tell him to stop drooling on the bishop, but yours is better.
Haha, real funny, guys. Thanks a lot. So, Doc, are we done here? I'd like to head back to Mission Ops, see if Rook 9 or Pawn 19 need my help.
Stop calling me Doc. The remaining bullet fragments have been removed, and the nanites forcibly flushed from your system, as requested. So yes, Pawn 12, we are done here. You are free to go.
Hey, Doc, Kieran?
Rook 13.
Yes, Rook 13. Question. Do you ever smile?
Yes.
Right. Okay, then. It was nice having you, Pawn 12. Don't come back too soon.
I won't, believe me. This place sort of creeps me out. Well, if you want to come talk, Bishop, come see me in Mission Ops. Whatever.
You heard that. He's freaked out by you.
Many people do not like hospitals, and this room is no different from that environment.
Okay, boss. You keep telling yourself that. But hey, Bishop, what do you think? Did he scare away Pawn 12?
Yes, especially after the do you smile question.
You see?
I wish I could understand what you see, but I cannot. I feel that I conduct myself admirably with those around me.
What? You have got to stop saying things like that. You'll never find a wife at this rate.
I've never had time for marriage, or women in general. From what I understand, you take time and emotional investment, things I cannot give.
Okay, let's drop it. I'm sorry I spoke.
We both need to concentrate, Bishop.
I guess the Bishop saving your life hasn't done much to improve your personality?
Oh, Rook 13's quite the romantic, huh? Are you trying to get rid of me?
No, I am not. You may stay here if you wish. It makes no difference to me.
Well, this is certainly fun.
So are you guys... So... if I read it literally, so are you guys are in some kind of relationship?
Relationship? Don't be absurd. I would never hold sexual relations with a co-worker.
Aw, well, shucks. I had my hopes up in everything.
Why not? That's dumb.
Yeah, Kieran, don't be dumb.
This is hardly an appropriate discussion for the workplace.
Okay.
So, Pawn 24 and I need to concentrate, and you have orders.
We need to concentrate on what, exactly?
Our work.
Right, our work, of course. Sorry, Bishop, but we apparently have work to do. So much work.